Welcome to Zombie Outbreak Survival. I hope you're all having a great day. Today's video is about the zombie bag, how to make one, and why you need to. Zombies, of course, are a thing of fiction, and preparing for a zombie outbreak, however, is the same as preparing for most emergencies that come up in real life. The zombie bag is a dual-purpose bag. It can get you home if you're stranded with no help coming in a grid-down situation, or it can be used as an emergency evacuation bag. For example, if the police show up at your door letting you know you have to evacuate due to flood or fire or some other natural disaster, this bag will help you survive 2 to 4 days. More than enough time to get home from where you're stranded, and definitely more than enough time if you've been evacuated from your home. So let's take a look at the contents of this bag and how to put it together. So the first item we're going to look at here is on the outside of the bag, and that's water. And that's because you cannot survive more than 3 days without water. And as you can see, the bag I'm using holds 3 containers of water, 2 small ones and a larger one. And with the extra gear I have inside the pack, I'm able to secure extra water. The second and third items we'll do together. The second item is a compass, which will let you know if you're what direction you're heading in, which is very important. And the third, of course, is a laminated map. The reason I suggest this over a cell phone is because cell phone batteries die. A laminated map does not have batteries, and it'll be there for you. They're very rugged, and they do resist the elements very well. So the next item in our pack is 2 blue tarps. The color doesn't really matter. Point is, these are great for making various types of shelters. You can also use them to carry someone if they're injured by bringing up a travois. We'll leave more on that later, possibly. However, the many things you can do with the tarp make them absolutely invaluable. I would suggest if you have time, get a couple. Practice making the different types of shelters and find the one that best suits you. The second type of shelter setup that we have is a Mylar camping shelter for emergency backpacking. Now these, where they are made of Mylar, are designed to keep the heat in, to keep you warm. That's really important on those cold winter nights. The next item, one of my favorites when I'm hiking or camping, is the emergency poncho. Where I live, we get a lot of rain, and there's nothing worse than being soaked straight through to the skin, where all your clothes are sticky, heavy, and miserable. This will protect you from that, keeping you warm and dry as you walk carefully back to your home or to wherever you're going, whether it be your camp or your cabin. The next item is not one that I have in the bag all year round. It's mainly for the spring and summer, and that's a mosquito head net. There is nothing more annoying than mosquito bites. The next item in our bag is really, really invaluable. It is the emergency blanket. It is made of Mylar, and it does a great job of keeping the heat in. I've seen on one video where a gentleman, whose name I cannot remember at this point, as this was a few years ago that I seen the video, made a shelter with a plastic painter's sheet on the front side and used one of these on the back side. Had a fire in front of his encampment, and it kept the heat in very, very nicely. The last thing you want to have when you're trekking through the woods or trying to get home, the last thing you really want is hypothermia. It is nasty. Take care of yourself. Make sure you have a few of these in your pack. Now this next item might seem a little odd, but I swear by it. It is a great item to have in any kit, and that would be cheesecloth. When you're trying to prepare water, for example, purify it. If you don't have purification tablets or bleach, the best known way to purify water is to boil it. That being said, once the boiling is done, you take your water and you take your cheesecloth, put it over a second container, pour the water through it. It will strain out any particles. Now, I'm not talking microscopic particles. No, just regular stuff like dirt, twigs, stuff you really don't want to swallow. Another important item for that 72-hour clock is food. As you can see, I have 4 packages of Ben's Original Fast and Fancy rice and vegetable mixes. On the upper top, in the clear see-through baggie, there's about 4 to 6 pouches of oatmeal. And just in case he Uncle Ben's needs a little bit of salt and pepper, that's what you see in the lower left-hand corner. Salt and pepper packages. Very lightweight, easy to transport, and as I said, gives a little flavor to your food. This next item, and very important to have, a first aid kit. Some of the things you should add to it though, if you are on any prescription medications for any problems or health issues, make sure you have a small bottle of a few extra pills for that to last you a few days. It's very important to have that. That way you can keep going, get back to where you need to safely. This next set of items is our fire starting kit, which will allow you to boil your water, cook your food, and keep you warm. Now, if we start with the upper left, you're going to see a bottle of Ronson's lighter fluid, two Bic lighters, an orange container to hold matches. The inside of that top of the container has a little clear glass you can use as a small signaling mirror, and of course a whistle at the other end. And on the upper right, the final item would be, of course, steel and flint. On the bottom, starting from the left, we have fire fuel sticks. In the middle, we have my favorite fire starting tinder, which would be simply dryer lint from Knowing Your Laundry. It's free. You can't beat that price. And the final item is a retractable saw used for cutting timber. As you can see, I've got various ways of making a fire, and if I can't make a fire out of that, then something is definitely wrong. But nothing beats practice. As my father always said before he passed on, the more I practice, the luckier I get at doing it. The next item, and a very important item that you need in your pack, is of course a sharp knife. Now, as you can see, this is a very small knife. I chose this simply because with this pack, I only expect to be cutting rope, cordage, any small sticks I can break, and I've got the retractable saw if I need to break or cut down any larger limbs to feed into my fire. But for what I'm planning this pack for, now simple to get home, this knife will do. However, that being said, should you put a kit together like this and you want to upgrade it to more expensive gear, the knife is one of the first things you should upgrade. And the next item coming out of our bag would be cordage. On the left, we've got the yellow bundle of rope that can actually, if you need to, split down into different strands so that you have more cordage. The blue one is simply a smaller and more flexible type. And of course, there's a wrist bracelet of paracord, and that does come with its own little compass in it. I wouldn't trust how accurate it is, but it's a backup. So next up is our mess kit. The silver bowl is what I use to cook my Uncle Ben's rice meals in, my porridge, and I usually use a spoon or the knife, depending on what I'm making down below. Metal cup is, of course, so I can have my cup of tea. Without that, I'm not exactly human. In fact, I'm not human at all with a cup of tea first thing in the morning. The blue mess kit consists of a plate, bowl, fork, knife, and spoon, and a drinking cup, which of course my wife picked out for herself. So now we come to the extra set of tent peg. You can either buy little plastic ones like these at the dollar store, come in a set of six, or any other store that sells camping equipment, or you can simply use a tree branch or a stick. I'm good either way, but it's always nice to have a couple that you know aren't going to break too easily. Next up are a couple of pot holders. Now, the reason I use these is that they're small, they're foldable, they're lightweight, and I can use either one of those to pick up a hot bowl out of the fire without burning my finger. The last thing we need is injuries. The next two items consist of our source of light, a small battery-operated lantern that apparently can be used as a flashlight. However, this particular model doesn't give off enough light through the top to do that, but we do have our regular small mini flashlight, which does provide enough illumination. The way we planned on using these was to basically hang this in wherever we're camping out at, stopping for the night, and if one of us needs to get up for the washroom in the middle of the night, there's the handheld to get us back. This next item is a couple of D-rings. One has a few key rings on it, so I can hang extra items off my pack or off my belt. One of the things they're good for as well, with the extra coil of rope that's included in the pack, able to hang up the food so that animals cannot get at it. Now, this next group of items are basically for health reasons, of course. If you're basically trying to get back to your home during the middle of a pandemic, which we now know can and probably is going to happen again, given everything the government's been saying and doing, all I'm going to say on that one there, we have rubber gloves, N95 mask, extra Kleenex, hand sanitizer, ballistics, and of course chapstick. Now, these next two items are a little bit of a just-in-case sort of thing. I always tend to keep an extra pair of shoelaces just in case one of mine break, and of course a can opener, bottle opener, just in case. Now these last item I have in my bag is basically just tea bags for a nice hot drink. I also have powdered milk, which I have not shown in this video, and that's basically for morale purposes and to have something warm going down inside you, you know, just to maintain body temp. And of course one thing, tea, or for you coffee drinkers, it's a good way to start the morning. Just because things are falling apart and everything's crashing down around you doesn't mean you can't or shouldn't have a cup of tea or coffee. Now there are a lot of other items that can be added onto this, into this bag. As I said, this will last 3 days with the way I have it packed for both me and my wife. Of course, she has a bag where we put the extra things like extra socks and underwear, change of clothes, and extra miscellaneous items that aren't mentioned here. If you want to check out my other videos, they're right here. Have a good watch, and thank you so much for being there.